there was another hormone that you mentioned in conjunction with melatonin that, at least in mice, was purported to cause longevity, but together they potentiated each other.
Okay, that's Dr. Walter Pierpaoli's work, yes, as you pointed out. He has been working with animal longevity because really you can't be around long enough to do this with people longevity. Right. So getting down to the animals, he found that melatonin would extend the lifespan about yay much, somewhat, but statistically significantly. Mm-hmm. And then a hormone called thyroid-releasing hormone from, it actually comes from pituitary gland, and it's one of many jobs is to stimulate the thyroid gland. But that increased the stimulating hormone, TRH, increased the lifespan. But if you put them together, mm-hmm, it didn't do an additive effect, it did a multiplier effect, and there was a much greater longevity. Now, all the hormones have a certain name, but let's take thyroid-releasing hormone. It's been found to do a dozen other things in the body that have nothing to do with stimulating the thyroid. Mm-hmm. But each one has its original name, and so particularly in academic circles, that's what it does, that's all it does. And unless you're a researcher in the area, you don't even think of all the things that it can be done. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So there are obviously limitations. Some states will say you can't prescribe growth hormone. They didn't say you can't use it, so you'd have to go to another state, get it prescribed, mm-hmm, utilize it, because it's not just for growth hormone, it's also for rejuvenation.
Right.
Is this something that's appropriate for people who are tested to be low, say an IGF-1? And I've heard also of the use of IGF-1 as, mm-hmm, a rejuvenative benefit.
Well, we're very able to measure growth hormone itself. Mm-hmm. It's done in the same urine collection in which all the other hormones are measured. And I prefer to measure the hormone itself. Remember, it comes out at night too.
Yes.
So you check it in the daytime and, okay. So you can get your levels measured. And then, very fortunately, there's some things that stimulate growth hormone from the inside. And the best one is good old exercise like you do, the interval training.
Right.
That really stimulates growth hormone.
Yeah.
And that, you don't have to ask your state authorities if you can interval train. Oh, wait a minute. I'm sorry. Tomorrow they might pass a law against that too. But anyway,
right. At least for now.
At least for now.
Exercise intensely, where you're really breathing heavy and you're moving hard and fast. Good.
Right. And actually, some researchers pointed out why it works. Because when we do that, you've heard, our bodies produce lactate. And if we reduce too much of that, we get muscle problems.
Yeah.
And it's the lactate which directly stimulates the growth hormone.